Here we are, live at Crybaby Hill, the night before the race.
Drink.
Sloan, we have some special guests with us tonight.
This is a crazy night. We just set up. It's the night before the party. The biggest race. Our Mardi Gras is upon us. Laura, thank you so much for everything you do.
Aww.
Will you introduce us to your drunken uncle?
So this is my drunken uncle, known by some as Bucky. Known by some as Fred. I have found that some people call him Fred for whatever reason. And he is my drunken uncle and has been part of my life forever.
Here's to Fred.
Fred!
Welcome to your drunken
Slancha.
Uncle.
Thank you very much.
Fred.
We used to take her deer hunting. And she was tiny. And she would go deer hunting with her brothers and her dad, and we would all go hunting with her. And she was a good little hunter. She stuck it out with us. You had sisters, didn't you?
Anna.
Yeah, she was terrible at it.
You
were good at it.
I think Anna was better than me.
There's video evidence.
That might be.
Oh, she's not going to stretch it while she's on camera.
No.
A mismemory.
Anna's going to see this and she's going to be like, bullshit.
Well, we're at Crybaby Hill at kind of my house, kind of her family's house. You used to celebrate Christmas in this house.
Yep.
She can go in and remember where the Christmas tree was when she was little. And that's kind of, and now we do this.
And it's ground zero Crybaby Hill. I mean, this is the primo spot on the hill. This house, everyone focuses on it.
This is the king of Crybaby Hill.
I mean, Fred, why do you like it? Why do you agree to have this madness on your lawn every year?
No choice.
Well, let's actually backtrack
on that.
When we said baby three times.
Let's actually backtrack on that. And Bucky, if you don't mind, how long have you lived here?
I moved in 12 years ago.
So you've been here for the entire time of Crybaby Hill.
The first year I came back from Grand Lake, I've been up to the lake, it was Sunday, and they wouldn't let me in my neighborhood.
You didn't know about it.
And I said, what the fuck?
Right, you didn't know about it.
I had no clue.
Wow, that's
and a shocker. I used to ride bikes, and so I walked down here, and there's a bike race going on. There's nobody here. And I got my hose out, and I started spraying the riders when it went by, because it was hot.
Really?
That's great.
And that was it. And what shocks me
is
the first Crybaby Hill.
Yeah.
No, I don't want to claim that because the party started across the street. Truly across the street. But that first year, I was spraying the bikers, and they came up, the race people said, can we pass that water to the bikers' yard? I said, sure. So I filled it up, filled the water bottles up my hose, and that was the first year. There was really nobody here.
Right.
And it amazed me. The paper had a picture of me last year. Of just me sitting out here in a lawn chair spraying, and it was just me. I don't know where the hell they got the picture. But and then the next year, some of the Sound Pony guys apparently moved in across the street.
Yeah.
And the rest is history. They created the party. I've just joined it.
But are you happy you joined it?
Oh, yeah.
This is amazing.
It's amazing what volunteer labor can do. And the logistics of putting this together is, most of us supposed to basically have to take a week off work. I mean, it's just the way it is, but it gets done. And my friends come by, they drop by and say, what can we do to help? And none of them show up on Monday.
we'll be here Monday with Buck and Bloody Mary next.
And soccer.
We have the Irish game and we'll be here.
Yeah, last year they were, they had a glitter cannon in the front yard.
Oh,
and glitter can make a mess.
I hate that shit.
And it was everywhere. It's still everywhere.
Glitter's a messy thing.
Glitter's messy, but it is magical and beautiful.
Okay.
Unless you have the
unless it's on your floor.
It's on my floor right now. It's probably on my leg. Like, if I look, I can probably find a piece of glitter right now.
Then the other conversation piece I have right over here where my trash cans usually are is the condom we found 2 years ago that's still unopened. And I'm waiting
and
for whoever lost it to come back
and claim
it.
Yeah.
It's
Tell us about
it. I was looking for that.
Tell us about the story. Damn it, I needed that later in the night.
No, no. The family that comes back, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, with a 2-year-old.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no, there no, it no is. Children. There's the condom that could change my
this
life.
This tree was completely full. The one behind us was full of rubber toys last year. Because everybody brought their inflatables and they threw them
right
in the tree.
Well, I hope they do it again. I would suggest... If you have you inflatables, you throw them up. We want your dirty underwear. God.
All right, so Fred, what's the most memorable private deal? What's your best memory from private deal?
Hey, Eric!
I would have to say it was Wonder Woman.
Okay, tell us that story.
5 years ago, Wonder Woman was in the front yard. Wonder Woman was truly beautiful. Wonder Woman took a lot of pictures with me, let me sweat on her. I think her husband or something was riding it. But she was beautiful.
She was Wonder Woman.
And she's never come back. Well, she's come back, but never as Wonder Woman. But she was, oh yeah, I've got lots of pictures still. Yeah, it's that week. And then I get a lot of pictures. I get really popular this week. It's really kind of...
Of course, yeah. Well, yeah, you're the center of attention.
Everything's
the center of attention. Just say you're welcome.
Hi.
You're all sit on the ground.
This is my right hand, Jamie.
Hi.
Hi, Jamie. Welcome.
Thank you. And she's very pretty. She's one of the first women, young ladies I adopted in Tulsa.
Yes.
And she's been adopted for a while. I didn't ever have my own kids, but I have lots of others. So,
really?
Yeah.
That's nice. Your drunk uncle.
What do you do, Buggy?
Exactly. Yeah, tell us.
I'm a lawyer.
Really?
I work in oil and gas lawyer. But, yep, I'm an oil and gas lawyer. And really, I do this anymore. This is fun. I mean, look at my street tonight. It's awesome.
Nice.
So much energy.
I mean,
here.
they essentially bring because this is how we describe it. They essentially bring Mardi Gras to your town. For eight hours. And it's I've been here several years, and it's a madhouse, wonderful explosion of energy.
Yeah, don't bring your kids, don't bring your dogs.
You cannot even describe it to anyone.
And drop your morals before you walk in.
It's crap.
I don't have any morals. Hey!
Have
I don't have nothing to drop. I got nothing to drop.
And our energy is so good, too, because everybody is just cheering on these cyclists, and we're all just happy to be out acting like lunatics.
It's pure energy. It's pure, positive,
but you wouldn't
weird
know
energy.
That. Yeah.
No, that has to go somewhere, though.
The rest of the world
somewhere.
Has no clue
it's
what
out
goes
into
on
space.
On this street for 8 hours tomorrow.
Do you think it's changed over time? Do you think this event has become more well-known?
Oh, it's certainly become more well-known. I am amazed that the guys who will be behind me back here, the referees and the ref people, the race people all together, it stays under control. I don't have any idea how.
Volunteer work, like you said earlier.
Yeah, a lot of good volunteers, a lot of people working hard. You know, I'm afraid one day the one drunken idiot will screw it up, and he'll be that fraternity guy and I want to tell everybody, if that fraternity asshole is your friend, is the one that's always the fuck up, leave him home tomorrow.
Your drunken uncle
audience,
advice.
Did you just hear Bucky?
Yeah, we don't need that.
Leave that shit home.
Leave the douchebag at home.
Yeah, and it will happen because one day he'll stagger out in the street, then a fight will start, and it'll be just.
But up until now, it has been a pretty
peaceful. It's amazing.
It's a symbiosis between the crowd and the homeowners.
Oh
right?
Yeah, well, sort of. I'm not gonna swear on any of the other homeowners. I chose to join it. Some of them are probably mad at me.
I would jump in on this.
Okay, guys.
Or move.
I'll say to you guys. I'm going to have a yard full of beautiful women tomorrow.
And this is a fellow drunken uncle.
Who
right
are
going to
be wearing very little clothing. And about it's going to be hot enough, about 2:30 tomorrow, I'm going to get out the hose. And I'm going to start spraying them. Okay?
And that is Crybaby.
And that is your drunken uncle on Crybaby Hill. Crybaby Hill is a little crazy.
I'm going to spray them, and I'm going to
name it for
and they're
going to
squeal and yell and... And then come running up. Yeah, it's awesome.
Everybody from the left and from the right have to loosen up, let go, like you said, loosen up your morals, let go of your morals, and just expose yourself to this moment, because it is just a rare, weird thing that just happens.
It is. Mm-hmm. Jamie said, told me or not, she had her outfit picked out, but it was a little bit white on top.
Oh, shit.
And you're going to have a hoax.
That might be.
And I said, oh, yeah.
That might be a disadvantage.
Give me a target.
You
can
poke a dot bikini underneath.
Yeah. No, I mean.
I don't know if we brought our flask. Did we bring our flask? I think I have my flask. Well, you need to go get my flask.
Where is it?
We can't hear anything that you're saying.
Yeah, they're all whispering.
They're talking about a flask.
Can you hear anything we're talking about?
It's a flask.
A little bit?
Uh-huh, they're
we're talking about alcohol, if you want to know.
Where's the whiskey?
Donday is the gym assignment.
It rained. Another great year was 2 years ago when it rained.
Yeah, yes.
And the mud year. And I had no grass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I was here that. I was here that.
And it was just mud.
It was actually fun. Yeah.
And then the jello shot lids started coming up with the grass.
Oh, yeah.
Because they've been stomped down into the mud.
Yeah.
I remember
so the grass grew. Jello shot lids on top of it.
There was a flip-flop.
Flip-flop. We had a flip-flop.
It took like 6 months to grow
come all the way out of the ground. Yeah.
It was amazing.
Yeah, beer cans would be raised back up slowly. I mean, by the July 1st, the grass was back.
That's
no big deal.
Hilarious.
It didn't take long.
No, it's Bermuda, for God's sake. We can't kill it.
No, you can't. Killing it.
We can try.
And good.
I mean, just on behalf of everyone who comes out here, I certainly appreciate your willingness to allow us to destroy your lawn and just,
you know what, worst things have happened in life. And what'll be really funny is if you come back on Sunday and there'll be, alongside the house, there'll be a spot where somebody left the ice chest and it'll still be green. There'll be a green spot where ice chests were. It's part of the experience. You know, I really hope my neighbors, I mean,
I think they buy in. Look at what they're doing over there.
They got
they're
their fences up now and everything. You know,
yeah, they're setting up.
We're learning. Yeah. And
it's a huge audience.
It's an amazing thing for Tulsa.
Well, I've got some guys from Texas who take a spot in my yard every year. And the head guy on Facebook says to me tonight, he had a big wreck. And so he couldn't make it this year, but he's having a watch party of Crybaby Hill at his apartments.
On the internet,
on the internet. They're going to have a watch party. So,
that's awesome.
You know,
that's
so we're spreading.
That is awesome.
It is awesome.
Go, Tulsa, go.
Yeah, I mean, who knew? And, you know, the other races are a lot of fun, too. This isn't just
man.
Yet. Yeah, it's
my weekend of races.
And you know what's really cool also today? Earlier today, we're on the park that you're watching the bikers from all over the world come up here and take pictures of themselves
on
the hill. You know, they're posing on the hill.
Right.
And that's kind of cool to see that.
Selfies on the hill.
You know, it's international.
It's a tough ride, man. It's a tough ride.
Yeah. And that, now I'm gonna throw the gauntlet down.
The gauntlet. Here we go.
In a year, I'm gonna ride this something.
Oh yeah! What? No.
Right here.
What? Your drunken uncle.
What?
You heard it first.
You heard it first. Like your drunken uncle.
Fred Bucky Buxton.
Breaking news.
Riding it
next year.
Breaking news.
We have it. We have it on camera.
Oh my God!
I just committed myself.
Yeah. Bucky, this is going on the internet.
Yeah. Now the world knows.
The world knows that you're gonna be a racer.
I'm gonna ride this some bitch next year.
All right. We believe it.
I've ridden it.
Your drunken uncle will sponsor you.
I will be right here.
He will sponsor you.
Screaming your name.
I didn't say a whole race. I'm gonna get around.
We'll pay for space.
Yeah.
On your back.
All right. Cool.
That will be absolutely twittered and tweeted.
We will sponsor.
Twittered.
We're gonna be there with the training.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah.
Done.
I'm gonna drop 75 pounds. I'm gonna ride this.
Done.
Really?
No. He has told me multiple times that this is his goal. He's going to drop weight and by next year at this time.
Well, tell me the magic.
Yeah.
How do you lose weight? Because I want to lose weight.
I don't know. I'm 57.
I'm trying to lose weight without drinking. That's the compliment.
You mean without quitting?
Without quitting drinking.
Yeah.
I don't think it's possible.
You said I'm trying to lose weight without drinking.
We're going
to
go for alcohol, not
beer. No, I want to drink and lose weight.
Right, right.
That's why I said,
is
this part of your pizza beer diet?
Yeah. Why does the pizza beer diet work?
It doesn't. I've tried it.
Yeah. Hey, Bucky. My question is,
We land people on the moon. We got robots on Mars. Yep. Why the hell can't they come up with pizza beer diet that works?
Right.
Well, they would call it.
Come on, that's what we want.
They would call it vegetarian. What's the
gluten free?
Gluten free.
Yeah, but that doesn't
anything
work.
That's good, yeah. You can't eat it.
I know.
Yeah.
Anything that's healthy.
Good.
Anything good, you can eat it, but then it's like then it's, damaging. Yeah.
I think you can lose weight the way you're talking. I think it's called malnutrition. I think you eat zero nutrients, and eventually you start losing weight.
Yeah, but this
is not recommended by your drunken uncle.
No.
Your drunken uncle says eat. Your drunken uncle says eat food.
Eat food.
Yeah, I'm next. I've ridden a bike before. I know I can do it.
That's good.
I got a $2,000 bike sitting in the back room in this house.
There you go.
You know, it was $2,000 in 1999 when I bought it, you know, but I can get the sumbitch out and
put those little
click in shoes and buy a silly helmet and buy those pants that you know, hurt your
nuts. That silly helmet is actually really good to have.
You can train.
And I can train here. You're right.
I know. You have it right here. You can do all the training you want.
Maybe I'll just ride down the hill.
You know, those riders that come in from Spain, they don't have this exact hill. They have hills, but
they don't have this hill. Right.
That's right.
Uh-huh. Got to get back up yourself.
I mean,
nope, I'll do it in a year. I'll put it on record.
I know.
You can put it on Facebook.
Oh, no, this is not even record. This is big.
This is more
this
than...
This is beyond Facebook. This is going on Facebook.
This is more than Facebook.
This is going on YouTube. This is... Like I said, this is going out.
Man. But the whiskey's still tasting good before I quit, and I didn't say I was quitting. I went dead. Going to record.
Oh, yeah.
But I got to slow down. You're going to have to. I mean, come on. I'm 57 in a week. So, yeah.
Well,
we're behind you. 100%.
We are...
You can do it.
We're your fellow drunken uncle. We're a decade behind you. And I love your MO. I love what you're doing. And if we can roll like you 10 years from now.
I mean, it's hard to describe abide. How crazy
he abides.
No.
Can you explain?
He does?
No, you
are
you.
It's
you,
Lebowski reference.
You,
what does it get like?
It is.
The Big Lebowski?
There will be several thousand people.
The Big Lebowski.
In this
half a block. And they won't be wearing much. And it's hot, and it's a drinking destination. Let me just put it that way.
That's
I mean, people come here because they're going to get wasted.
I say.
And then they fall down everywhere too. That's another fun thing about Crybaby Hill.
In the rain, if
I heard it's productivity on Monday is going down.
Yeah, take Monday off. Oh,
yeah.
I am.
Yeah, I mean, everybody. If I was running a company in Tulsa, I'd be like.
Take
you have
off.
The day off.
It's
like Super Bowl Sunday. It's like, why?
Hey, Sloan, will your drunken uncle be taking Monday off?
No. We'll be drinking and watching the Irish defeat the Swiss.
Soccer.
In European finals.
Football.
Euro Cup.
Football.
Yeah,
but football.
It's always worked for your drunken
football.
Uncle.
Football.
Always
I
work.
Don't know. I want to work the next day.
I want to rewind a little bit. Yeah, I have to work. I have to work Monday. I have to. But I want to rewind to this whole idea of people drinking here. I heard the funniest news piece I've heard in a long time, and it was weather. I mean, funny weather. They were talking about how hot it's going to be and how, in preparation for Crybaby Hill and everybody getting out and staying in the sun, they need to make sure and drink a lot of water and make sure that they're not drinking any alcohol because that's going to make everyone get overheated and have heat stroke. And I was like,
exactly.
What? All right, let's just all stay home.
I mean,
let's just stay home.
But first of all, this is actually not going to be a very hot Crybaby Hill.
What, 90s?
Three years ago, it was 100.
Something like that.
Three years ago.
I've been here and it was a lot hotter, man.
And the other amazing things about Crybaby Hill is the Jell-O shots come from everywhere.
That's so true.
I don't know where they all come from, but they're here by the thousands. And there was a cute little girl on a bicycle last year who was just selling Jell-O shots. That's what she was doing. I mean, I love the entrepreneurship that shows up here.
Well, we have it right here. We have a little entrepreneur going on this time.
I mean, they're probably selling the bad acid down there. I don't have any.
Don't. We're going to be on the mega
Don't eat the brown acid.
The brown acid.
Brown acid is bad.
Do not eat the brown acid.
The brown acid's bad.
Your private meal says do not
We've
eat
got
the brown
the
acid.
Yeah.
Fred, thank you so much.
You bet, guys.
Yeah, Fred, thank you so much.
It was a blast.
You're a fellow drunken uncle, man.
Cheers.
You're a totally fellow drunken uncle, man.
I told you.
You told us. Yeah. Laura.
Yeah, I'm not bad.
You're doing your job, Laura. You're doing your job.
Is she a talent scout here?
She is. She's organizer, talent scout.
Have you gone to her uncle's tree? Have you taken him to your tree?
No. What's the uncle's tree?
Her uncle was my best friend.
I heard that.
No, we didn't know that.
And he used to live here. He would have loved this event. Dex Mason God. You know, he was a cyclist himself, and he would have just loved it. And he would have been running in a Speedo up the street with a sombrero. That would have been Lex. Yeah. just would have. I can't. Lex was a goofy old fucker.
Where's his tree?
Is it Zink Park?
Yeah.
We need to do an honorarium.
A little pilgrimage on there. I just happened to be in the neighborhood, and
Maybe we should do that. We can tie that into this.
Yeah, he was a heck of a guy, and I miss him every day.
Thank you.
And I kind of do this in his honor.
Cheers.
To a certain extent. So.
Cheers.
What's his name?
His name was Lex Mason.
Uncle Lex Mason.
George Lex Mason.
Your drunken uncle Lex Mason. Cheers.
He was her truly drunken uncle, but I'll do my best to stand in.
But you're the adopted drunken uncle.
You're doing a good job.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds like you're doing a great job.
He was a goofy fucker. God. Yeah. Stay about him.
All right.
No, nay, never, no more will we play drunken uncle. No, never.